Can you imagine a world where one day, if you need a new heart, you could just order one made just for you? Sound like science fiction? Well, it's not so far off. Hey guys, Julia here for DNews. Dude, so something pretty cool just happened in the wonderful world of science. Researchers grew beating hearts from human stem cells. Okay, fine, that's a little bit of hyperbole. It's not the whole heart, but just a few beating cells, but it's still really cool. In one study published in the journal Nature, the researchers used human skin cells, turned them into pluripotent cells, and then used physical and chemical signals to coax the cells into forming little cardiac microchambers, which could be important for studying how the heart grows in an embryo, or how drugs might affect a fetus's heart, or looking way into the future for growing hearts in a dish. It could be a great way to replace organs. No more waiting for a donor, and since it would be perfectly matched to your body, no more terrible drugs to prevent rejection. So far, smaller organs like tracheas and bladders have been grown in a lab using a person's own stem cells, but a heart is a little more complicated. So let's take a little look into how we got here. First of all, what are stem cells? Stem cells are pluripotent, meaning they are undifferentiated cells that can develop into any kind of cell, like skin, heart, liver, etc. So, alright, what's the big deal? Why do researchers love to study stem cells? Even from the earliest inklings of stem cells, there have been big dreams. Researchers have hoped that one day we could be able to grow entire new organs from stem cells that would be a perfect match for the recipient. We've come a long way from the early days of stem cell research. Human stem cells were first isolated in 1998 by two independent research teams, one led by James A. Thompson of the University of Wisconsin, and another by John D. Gearhart of Johns Hopkins University School of Medicine. Those early stem cell lines were derived from embryos, which are destroyed in the process, and thus stirred a little bit of controversy. Okay, it stirred a lot of controversy. Because of the debate that raged in the US surrounding embryonic stem cell research, scientists looked to find stem cells in other adult tissues. So a few years later, in 2001, adult stem cells were found in fat tissue. Now, adult stem cells can be found in almost any tissue, but they're a little tricky. They take a while to coax into growing in a dish, so they're not ideal. But in 2007, in a paper published in the journal Nature Biotechnology, Dr. Anthony Atala discovered that amniotic fluid also contained stem cells, which of course only added more fuel to the debate. And the same year, two independent teams of researchers pioneered a process to turn adult somatic cells into pluripotent stem cells, naturally called induced pluripotent stem cells. The process involves introducing four different genes into the cells using a virus as a carrier. The team from Japan, led by Shinya Yamanaka, published their work in the journal Cell, and the team led by James Thompson at the University of Wisconsin-Madison published their work in the journal Nature, and it was such a huge deal that Yamanaka actually won the 2012 Nobel Prize for discovering iPS cells. And of course, this discovery held a lot of promise. It would sidestep some of the controversy surrounding embryonic stem cells, but there are more than a few issues with this technique, like low efficiency. It's difficult to do, and when done, only a few cells are reprogrammed. Plus, there's weird problems with rejection, and also a problem with tumors developing. But problems aside, tons of studies have been and are being done with this technology, with lofty goals, like attempting to cure blindness and diabetes. The Federation of American Societies for Experimental Biology says that iPS cells will allow scientists to study complex human diseases in petri dishes, a step toward analyzing the conditions and developing therapies. Some researchers, like Dr. Atala, don't care where stem cells come from, just that they work well. No matter where stem cells come from, it's clear that we're on the road to organs grown in a dish. Well, I certainly hope so, but it's also clear that more research is needed. And really, lab-grown organs can't come soon enough. If you want to know the challenges of living with an organ transplant and why they fail, check out this recent video I did right here. 29,000 organ transplants are performed in the US every year, but it's a tricky business. Matches are rare and a rejection can get pretty nasty. And rejections happen more than you think. Alright guys, it's your turn to debate. Let us know how you feel about the difference between embryonic stem cells versus iPS cells. Tell us down in the comments below. Don't forget to hit those like and subscribe buttons, and keep coming back here to DNews. We've got new episodes every day of the week.